My grandma, she built a house over in Jamaica. Not straight away or nothing like that. But when my grandma came over, obviously she was a little kid or whatever, went to school and shit like that, whatever in it, boom. But she bought a house in England as well. So yeah, so she bought a property in England. I don't know, I don't want to say it was more of an old school mentality, but I think the old school generation, so let's say the young 21-year-olds, the youths them who were like 21 in the 70s, I think they had more of a smarter mentality than maybe a lot of us now, I think. Yeah, I can't really say for certain, yeah? But they had more of a I'll call it more of a traditional mentality, innit? So let's say the people them who is like 60, 70 years old now, when they were 21, it was like, I don't believe in marriage, but for them it was like get married, buy a house and have a kid kind of thing. Whatever. Yeah, whatever order it came in, getting married first or buying a house or buying a house, getting married, then having a kid, whatever order it came in. They had that more traditional mentality. And yeah, for the most part, it probably did work. Yeah, it probably did work out in their favor, innit? Yeah, because a lot of the people who are like 40 years old and 30 years old now, they're kind of benefiting from their parents' this kind of old school mentality. Yeah. Now, our children, yeah, so our generation, so if you're between the age of 20 and 35, yeah, I'll say we're all kind of same generation, whatever, innit? Yeah. A lot of our children might not benefit, yeah, because a lot of us are just paying rent. Yeah. Throwing money in the bin. Yeah. Yeah. Whereas a lot of the older generation, like my grandma's generation, all of my aunties and that, yeah. Well, actually, no, one of them, but that's an uncle. But anyway, all of my grandma's generation, bar one or two, they all have their own property. Yeah. And this is at the age of, young age, yeah, 21, 25, yeah, young people age, 30 years old. What? I've got what? A couple, what? How many friends have I got that have their own property? One. I've got one friend off the top of my head who has his own property. Yeah. Now, it's not because my other friends in that have shit jobs. Yeah. They're doing well for themselves. Yeah. It's just, I don't know why they don't have this mentality to buy a property, even if you're not going to live in it. Yeah. They don't even have the mentality to buy the property to even rent it out. And they're not stupid people. So it's not a thing of where they're not buying the property because they want to buy a Balenciaga. Don't get it twisted. I know men like that. Yeah. But they're just not buying the property. I don't know what the fuck they're doing with their money. Oh no. Oh no. Well, yeah, they're paying rent. What am I talking about? Paying rent. But yeah, I definitely think it's more of an old school mentality to buy the house because it was more of like a family setting. Yeah. It was like a standard to, yeah, you must get married, you must buy a house, you must have kids. So those were like the three things. Yeah, it's like, whereas now, people don't really care about marriage and that. People having children later as well, I think. So yeah, they just the money is going straight in the rouse bin because they're paying rent. Try and avoid paying rent if you can. Obviously, if you move from Birmingham to London, well, you have no choice. But in that aspect of things, on that side of things, then just try and, rent somewhere as cheap as you can. That's practical to travel to work. Save as much money as you can. What happens is a lot of people, they get roped into paying high rent and then they ain't got much money left over. So they're like, what's the fucking point, yeah, of me paying high rent, not seeing any return from my rent, yeah, in an even long term, not seeing any return, sorry, not seeing any return from the money that I've put into this house, yeah, even long term. I'm left off with a couple of £100 after I pay all my bills and that. What's the point of fucking saving? So that's why they don't end up saving. Yeah. Listen, there's people walking around right now. Yeah, they even got a grand in their account. Yeah. There's people living paycheck to paycheck. Yeah. Because, and these people aren't even in debt. It's just these people, their bills are so high because of the lifestyle they maintain. I told you, I met a man who were earning 8, 10 grand a month. Yeah. Just like me. And man, I'm talking about he's broke at the end of the month. He's broke before even payday. What are you doing with your money? You got a yacht? You got a Lamborghini or something like that? Must be drugs. You know, a lot of these men all doing fucking weed and cocaine, and that must be some kind of drugs they're doing.